This question is phrased like you would see a real world problem that the manufacturing department in a car company might get asked. Instead of giving you just the number of items in each category, the problem gives you descriptions of the options. For example, an optional sunroof or a manual or automatic transmission. And from there, it's up to you to translate each of those options or choices into a number. Now, the way that I like to arrange this kind of question is by putting a line or a blank for each of the options or each of the choices that we have to make. In this case, we have four decisions for each car: the transmission type, whether or not it has a sunroof, a stereo option, stereo package, and the car's color. So to calculate the result, I'm going to start by putting the number of options for each of those choices in the blank above it. For the transmission, we have two options. It's either manual or automatic. For the sunroof, we also have two options. In this case, either the car has the sunroof or it doesn't. We can choose to put it on or we can choose not to put it on. The stereo, we have three packages to choose from. And finally, there are five color options. So now that we have all of the counts for all of our options filled in, we can use the multiplication rule to get the total number of combinations. Remember, the multiplication rule tells us that the total number of combinations is equal to the product of the number of choices, of the number we have in each of the individual choices. So if I multiply all of those numbers together, the manufacturing department has to be ready to produce 2 times 2 times 3 times 5, or a total of 60 different cars.